The oldest and strongest emotion of mankind is fear. And the oldest and strongest kind of fear is fear of the unknown.
Snakes on a Plane makes many attempts to follow the standards of a decent horror movie as set forth by Lovecraft's quote. However, its numerous subpar attempts causes the overall movie to be a crash and burn with the scare factor. Through the use of suspenseful music and a tracking shot, the previous scene begins to set up the fearful reaction for the audience, but it quickly loses its momentum as it fades to a new scene and leaves the watchers longing for more. Snakes on a Plane not only contains cinematic problems, but a variety of factual and continuity problems as well. Notice the tail number on this private jet. The one shown begins with Z. This is incorrect because all U.S. registered aircraft tail numbers begin with the letter N. This error is not only made once, but four times throughout the film. The next error occurs in the commencement of this timer. The timer is rigged to begin when the aircraft reaches a certain altitude. However, planes have pressurized cabins. Therefore, this timer would never be activated and the snakes wouldn't be released. In this scene, the special effects crew tries to enhance the goriness of the movie by making the gentleman's eyes foam. But in a quick angle change, the foam magically disappears. Take notice of the windows that were shot out by Agent 20. In the exterior shots, they remain the same as the original hull. Yet, when the shot cuts back to the interior, the hull expands. This just furthers the movie's many failed attempts at trying to live up to its expectations. If that wasn't noticeable enough, take a look at this. Observe Troy, wearing the big pumpkin orange shirt, exit the plane by way of the slide. But wait! Following his exit, the shot cuts back to the interior of the plane, and you see Troy traipsing down the stairway as if he never exited. The last inattention to detail comes in the closing scene. When Agent Flynn shoots the snake that attaches to Sean, blood spatters across Sean's shirt. Much like the foam in an earlier scene, it disappears out of the shot. But have no fear, with another angle change, it reappears and all is well.
Get it, Becca. You alright? Come on.
Snakes on a Plane's difficulty to get off the ground as a hit horror movie is exemplified through all of its poor cinematic qualities. As Samuel Jackson says it best,
"Enough is enough! I have had it with these monkey fighting snakes on this Monday to Friday plane! Everybody strap in!
I'm about to open some freaking windows.